What's up, Doc? It's Laura, in case you haven't guessed. It's Thursday, the 23rd, and I'm so bored.
She's dead. Wrapped in plastic.
Now it's dark. I don't understand.
Sort of evil out there. Something very, very strange in these old woods. Call it what you want, a darkness, a presence. It takes many forms, but it's been out there for as long as anyone can remember.
Thank you. February 24th, 1989. This morning, in the town of Twin Peaks, Washington, a dead body was discovered down by the shore, wrapped in plastic. Covered in blood, too many secrets left hidden under the skin. Drowned below, a fire burning the flesh in a whisper. This is a story of many, yet it begins with one, a young high school girl known to many in a small community. The one leading to the many is Laura Palmer. Laura is the one. Only a few could stand the sadness, pulling up their tears, holding not to be devoured by the flames. Fire. Touched by the devilish one, it has bared many names, though few could see through its eyes. A few miles from there, across the state line, emerges from the woods a second girl wandering down along the railroad tracks. Dazed, confused, torn by the scars and evil left on her face. Her name was Renette Pulaski, a desperate call that would echo throughout the darkness.
Diane, 11:30 a.m., February 24th. Entering the town of Twin Peaks. Never seen so many trees in my life. As W.C. Fields would say, I'd rather be here than Philadelphia. 54 degrees on a slightly overcast day. Weatherman said rain. You'd get paid that kind of money for being wrong 60% of the time. Be working. Mileage is 79,345. Gauge is on reserve. Riding on fumes here. I gotta tank up when I get into town. Remind me to tell you how much that is. Lunch was $6.31 at the Lamplighter Inn. That's on Highway 2 near Lewis Fork. That was a tuna fish sandwich on whole wheat, slice of cherry pie, and a cup of coffee. Damn good food. Diane, if you ever get up this way, that cherry pie is worth a stop. Okay. Looks like I'll be meeting up with the Sheriff Harry S. Truman. Shouldn't be too hard to remember that. We'll be at the Calhoun Memorial Hospital. Guess we're gonna go up to intensive care and take a look at that girl that crawled down the railroad tracks off the mountain. When I finish here, I'll be checking into a motel. I'm sure the sheriff will be able to recommend a clean place, reasonably priced. That's what I need. Clean place, reasonably priced. Oh, Diane, I almost forgot. Got to find out what kind of trees these are. They're really something.
Thank you.
Diane.
Damn good call.
Thank you.
Sheriff Harry S. Truman.
Dale Cooper, FBI. Pleasure.
Good to meet you. Have any trouble finding the place?
No. The place should be fine. I came out over Highway 2 near Lewis Fork. I stopped at a little place called the Lamplighter Inn. Had a slice of cherry pie. Incredible.
Well, I'll tell you, we're sure glad to have the FBI here. Kind of lucky in a way that Ronette stepped out across the state line. Whole town is really badly shaken up.
Nice, quiet place, something like this. Sheriff, let me stop you in the hallway here for just a second. There's a few things that we gotta get straight right off the bat. I've learned about this the hard way. It's best to talk about it up front. When the Bureau gets called in, the Bureau's in charge. And you're gonna be working for me. Sometimes local law enforcement has a problem with that. I hope you understand.
Like I said, we're glad to have you here.
Sheriff, what kind of fantastic trees have you got growing around here? Big, majestic.
Douglas firs.
Douglas Fir. Can someone get me a copy of the coroner's report on the dead girl?
Well, the autopsy hasn't been done yet, but I'll take you downstairs to the morgue when we're finished here.
I believe that I sat in a motel room like this with you when we first met. And I tried to convince you of the truth. And in that respect, I succeeded, but in every other way, I failed.
You don't believe that either.
I've been chasing after monsters with a butterfly net. You heard the man the date said, I can't change that.
You wouldn't tell me. Not because you were afraid or broken. But because you didn't want to accept defeat.
Well, could do to you. I was afraid that it would crush your spirit.
Why would I accept defeat? Why would I accept it if you won't? Although you say that you failed, but you only fail if you give up. And I know you. You can't give up. It's what I saw in you when we first met. It's what made me follow you. Why I'd do it all over again.
Look what it's gotten you.
And what has it gotten you? Not your sister. Nothing that you've set out for. But you won't give up, even now. You've always said that you want to believe. But believe in what, Palmer? If this is the truth that you've been looking for, then what is left to believe in?
I want to believe that the dead are not lost to us, that they speak to us as part of something greater than us, greater than any alien force. And if you and I are powerless now, I want to believe that if we listen to what speak, it can give us the power to save ourselves.
Thank you. Don't go there. Don't go there.
Diane.
Diane, I'm at the Twin Peaks County Morgue with the body of Eva Palmer. I got here before the autopsy. Diane, it's the same thing. I told you I had a feeling you'd see this again.
What do you got?
Ring finger, under the nail.
Let's see what he left us. It's an arm.
Diane, give this to Albert and his team. Don't go to Sam. Albert seems to have a little more on the ball. We need to bag and tag this.
Okay, Cooper. You gonna let me in on whatever the hell is going on here?
Sheriff, we got a lot to talk about.
Thank you. room. It's kind of like the firemen's. We just have to tough it out. You know, and shoot the stuff.
I want to let you know, on Monday, Beverly is going to come visit.
Why do we only have 2 days? We're in stages. Why do we have to do it in two days? Why?
I will tell you, in terms of Beverly, her availability, we have her for these 2 days, and that's it.
Well, there's a lot of scenes without Beverly. There's a shared training scene.
We also restart. We could Ben. Now this finishes Ben.
That finishes Ben.
So we pay him more money to keep him around.
Well, I know, but the thing is, like, you know, we're not on location where we have to, you know, that we aren't. We own the stages, you know. It just drives me nuts that we have to do something in 2 days. Somebody arbitrarily says you got to do it in 2 days. That fucking really pisses me off. It really does. We were always up against the fucking. I'm not working this way again, ever. This is absolutely horrible. We never get any extra shots. We never get any time to experiment. We never get to, you know, go dreamy or anything. We barely fucking make our days. I could have spent a week in the fireman's. I love that place. Dream up all kinds of stuff. You know, it's sick, this kind of fucking way to do it. You don't get a chance to sink into anything. It's not a way to work.
It gets.
Tell me I got 2 fucking days to do all these things. It's just bang, bang, bang. It's like a fucking machine.
It gets slightly better as we go into our spin tour.
Maybe we won't make it in 2 days. So start preparing for that.
It's not a big word. We just have to pay a bit more. This is just all old-fashioned planning of how movies are done in Hollywood. It's not the best way. It's just the way to do it efficiently.
Fucking hey, okay. What do you want me to do?
We're okay. We probably can do it. If the lighting's real slow, we may just say, let's come back and shoot that scene with Ben Moore in the morning. And the truth is, our next day in the sheriff's office, I think, is mellow.
What are you thinking about?
The Great Northern is a lot of work for us to do in 2 days. They're both full days. So there's not much wiggle room. It's kind of like the firemen's. We just have to tough it out. You know, and shoot the stuff.
I want to let you know, on Monday, Beverly is going to come visit.
Why do we only have 2 days? We're in stages. Why do we have to do it in two days? Why?
I will tell you, in terms of Beverly, her availability, we have her for these 2 days, and that's it.
Well, there's a lot of scenes without Beverly. There's a shared training scene.
We also restart. We could Ben. Now this finishes Ben.
That finishes Ben.
So we pay him more money to keep him around.
Well, I know, but the thing is, like, you know, we're not on location where we have to, you know, that we aren't. We own the stages, you know. It just drives me nuts that we have to do something in 2 days. Somebody arbitrarily says you got to do it in 2 days. That fucking really pisses me off. It really does. We were always up against the fucking. I'm not working this way again, ever. This is absolutely horrible. We never get any extra shots. We never get any time to experiment. We never get to, you know, go dreamy or anything. We barely fucking make our days. I could have spent a week in the fireman's. I love that place. I dream up all kinds of stuff. You know, that it's sick, this kind of fucking way to do it. You don't get a chance to sink into anything. It's not a way to work.
Tell
me I got 2 fucking...
Hello, Ashley and Mr. Goofer. See you again. Meanwhile.